Welcome to all for the lecture on electromagnetic field theory. Myself, Dr. Chandrasekhar M. Tawade, professor in ENTC department, Sheraj Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yadra. The content of the topic are introduction, basic of vectors, theorems used in field theory, Maxwell equations and conclusion. So introduction. So electromagnetic wave is combination of electric and magnetic waves. They are generated in a tank circuit of an amplifier. When the capacitor charges, electrostatic field is generated, and when the capacitor discharges through an inductor, magnetic field is generated. Electric and magnetic waves are mutually perpendicular to each other and they are transverse in nature. That is, the variation of electric and magnetic fields are perpendicular to the direction of propagation. The speed of EM wave is equal to the velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second in vacuum. So examples of EM waves are radio waves, microwaves, infrared waves, X-rays, gamma rays, etc. And EM waves are used in main telecommunication systems such as radio communication, television communication, radar communication, satellite communication and mobile communication, etc. So before going to study the theory of electromagnetic waves, it is necessary to know the knowledge of scalar and vector. It is vector algebra. Scalar is a quantity characterized by its magnitude only, whereas vector is a quantity which is characterized by both magnitude and direction. And there is another vector called unit vector. It is having magnitude equal to 1 and it is having direct, that is direction. So AX bar, AY bar, AYZ are the unit vectors. They are originating from origin and moving towards X, Y and Z axis. So another vector is a position vector where it starts from one point and ends with other point. So there are different coordinate system in the vector algebra. Those are the Cartesian coordinate system. The variables are x, y and z. Cylindrical coordinate system. The variables are r, phi and z. And spherical coordinate system. The variables are r, theta and phi. So the range of x, y, z are 0 to infinity in x axis. In y axis it is 0 to infinity and in z axis also it is 0 to infinity. In cylindrical coordinate system, the range of values of r are 0 to infinity, phi is from 0 to 2 pi and z is from minus infinity to plus infinity. In spherical coordinate system, the variables range is r is varying from 0 to infinity, theta is varying from 0 to pi and phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi. There are small element that is called differential elements. In x axis you can take dx, y axis dy and z axis dz. And in cylindrical coordinate system, small length along r axis is dr, along phi axis is r d phi, along z axis dz. In spherical coordinate system, small lengths are dr, r d theta and r sin theta d phi. So from the, you should know the what are the differential length. These are useful in the study of the electromagnetic field theory. Differential length dl bar is given by dx ax bar, dy ay bar plus dz az bar in Cartesian coordinate system. In cylindrical coordinate system, differential length dl bar is equal to dr ar bar plus r d phi a phi bar plus dz az bar. And in spherical coordinate system, dl bar is equal to dr ar bar r d theta a theta bar plus r sin theta d phi d phi bar. And also there are differential area in x plane, it is given by dy dz, and in y plane it is dx dz, and in z plane it is given by dx dy. And also in cylindrical coordinate system, in r plane it is given by r d phi dz, in phi plane it is dr dz, in z plane it is dr into r d phi. In spherical coordinate system, the in r plane the differential is given by r square sin theta d theta d phi, in phi plane it is r sin theta dr d phi, in phi plane it is dr into r d theta. And also there is a differential volume dv is equal to dx dy into dz in Cartesian coordinate system, and dv is equal to r dr d phi dz in cylindrical coordinate system. Dv is equal to r square sin theta dr d theta d phi in spherical coordinate system. There are dot product and cross product in vector algebra. So to find the dot product, a bar of a vector is given by a bar dot b bar is equal to ax bx plus ay bi az bz, where ax bx are the magnitudes along x axis and ay by are the magnitude along y axis, az bz are magnitude of the vectors a bar and b bar along z axis. So for the given problem, a is given vector with coordinates are 2, minus 5, minus 4, and for b vector the coordinates are 3, 5, 2, and to find the dot product you will get a bar dot b bar is equal to minus 27, where magnitude of a is given by under root of, that is ax square plus by ay square plus az square is equal to under root of 45, and magnitude of b bar is given by under root of, that is 3 square plus 5 square plus 2 square, it is under root of 32. And the angle between the two vectors is given by cos theta is equal to a bar dot b bar divided by magnitude of a bar and magnitude of b bar. It is given by, so theta is equal to cos inverse of this value equal to 130 minus 762 degree. Similarly, cross products of two vectors, their a bar plus b bar is given by a bar magnitude of a bar magnitude of b bar into sin theta, but in matrix form it is written as the ax bar unit vectors ay bar az bar, and the second row it is magnitude of a bar vector ax ay az, and the third row magnitude of b bar is bx by bz. So to calculate, we'll get the cross product of two vectors is equal to 10 ax bar minus 16 ay bar plus 25 az bar. So next, you should know what are the curl, gradient and divergent of vector. Curl of a vector is given by a bar cross b bar. In matrix form it is a bar, ay bar, az bar, and magnitude of, that is a that is vector a bar and magnitude of vector b bar. It gives the information of rotation of a field. Next, gradient of a scalar V is given by del V, where del is equal to, del is operator given by dou by dou x ax bar plus dou by dou y ay bar plus dou by dou z az bar in rectangular coordinate system. And gradient will give the information of slope of the vector V. That is, divergent vector A bar is given by dot product of del operator into vector del dot a bar is equal to dou by dou x ax plus dou by dou y ay plus dou by dou z az in Cartesian coordinate system. It gives number of flux lines diverging from a point. If the lines are coming from the positive charge outside the positive, it is called divergent. and when it is coming inside, it's called converging. Next, to find the gradient of the scalar fields in different coordinate system, suppose for v is equal to e raised to minus z sine 2x cos y in Cartesian coordinate system, then del v gradient of v is given by dou by dou x v x bar, dou by dou y v a y bar, dou by dou z v a z bar, and these dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou v by dou z are differentiated, and if substitute in this equation, we get del v is equal to this answer. Similarly, in cylindrical coordinate system, gradient of that is u is given by dou by dou r u plus 1 by r dou by dou phi u plus dou by dou z u, and these are calculated, using formula dou by dou r u dou by dou phi u dou by dou z u, and if substitute, will get this answer. Similarly, in spherical coordinate system, that is gradient of v w is given by dou by dou r w air bar plus 1 by dou 1 by r dou by dou theta w a theta bar plus 1 by r sin theta dou by dou phi w a phi bar. Then if you substitute and calculate the partial derivative, you will get dou by dou r w is equal to 10 sin square theta cos phi, dou by dou theta w is equal to 10 r 2 sin theta cos phi, dou by dou phi is equal to 10 r sin square theta into minus cos phi. You substitute, you will get the answer, and you can verify that. Next, to find the divergent and curl of vector, here suppose p bar is given as x square y z, x bar and x z bar, and q bar is equal to r sin phi a bar plus r square z a phi bar plus z cos phi z bar, and third one t bar is equal to 1 by r square cos phi r bar plus r sin theta cos phi a phi bar plus cos theta a phi bar. So here divergent is given by the formula del dot p bar is equal to dou by dou x ax plus dou by dou y ay plus dou by dou z az, where x is given as x square yz, ay is equal to 0, ez is equal to xz. If substitute, and simply we will get del dot p bar is equal to, a divergent of p bar is equal to 2xyz plus x in Cartesian coordinate system. In cylindrical coordinate system, divergence of q bar is equal to 1 by r dou by dou r r q r plus 1 by r dou by dou phi, that is q phi plus dou by dou z q z, where if you substitute that q r q phi and q z and take the partial derivative, we will get divergence of q bar is equal to 2 sin phi plus cos phi. Similarly, in spherical coordinate system, we will get divergence of t bar is equal to 1 by r square dou by dou r square tr plus 1 by r sin theta dou by dou theta t theta sin theta plus 1 by r sin theta dou by dou phi t phi, where tr is equal to 1 by r square cos theta and t theta is equal to r sin theta cos phi and t phi is equal to cos theta. If substitute and take the partial derivative here, we will get divergence of t bar is equal to 2 cos theta cos phi. Similarly, to find the curl in different coordinate system, in Cartesian coordinate system, curl of p bar is given by matrix form ax bar ay bar az bar unit vectors dou by dou x dou by dou y dou by dou z partial derivative, and px py pz are magnitude of the given vector. We can substitute here and solve. You will get curl of p bar is equal to minus z plus x square y ay bar minus x square z az bar. Similarly, to find the curl in the cylindrical coordinate system, the formula is del cross q bar is equal to 1 by r in the matrix A r bar, r f I bar, A z bar in vectors, partial derivative dou by dou r, dou by dou phi, dou by dou z, and the magnitude of vector q is q bar into r d phi and q z. Then if you substitute the values of q r is equal to r sin phi and q phi is equal to r square z and q z is equal to z cos phi and simplify, we'll get curl of q bar is equal to minus z by r sin phi minus r square r bar plus 3 r z minus cos phi a z. So similarly, in a spherical coordinate system, curl of t bar is equal to 1 by r square sin theta and unit vectors a r bar into r a theta bar r sin theta a phi bar and partial derivative dou by dou r, dou by dou theta, dou by dou phi and the magnitudes of t bar dr r d theta r sin theta d phi. If you substitute the value of dr is equal to 1 by r square cos theta and t theta is equal to r sin theta cos phi and t phi is equal to cos theta a phi in the matrix, and if you simplify this, we'll get curl of t bar is equal to cos 2 theta by r sin theta plus sin phi into bracket I r bar minus cos theta by r a theta bar plus 2 cos theta plus 1 by r q sin theta. Up to now we have studied the basics of vectors, that is dot product, cross product of two vectors, and also we have studied curl, divergent and gradient of the vectors, and also we have solved some of the problems in different coordinate system, that is Cartesian coordinate, cylindrical coordinate system, spherical coordinate system. There also important to know the triple product of the vectors. So one is scalar triple product, another one is vector triple product. Scalar triple product is given by A bar dot curl of B bar into C bar or B bar cross C bar, and vector triple product is given by A bar cross inside bracket B bar cross C bar is equal to B bar inside the bracket A bar dot C bar minus C bar inside the bracket A bar dot B bar. If you want to find the scalar triple product, if the given vector A bar is equal to 2x bar minus 1az bar and B bar is given as 2x bar minus ay bar plus 2az bar, and the C vector is equal to 2x bar minus 3ay bar plus az bar. So this scalar triple product A bar dot inside bracket B bar cross C bar is written in matrix form. The first row, magnitude of vector A bar are ax, ay and z, az, and the B bar vectors are bx, by, bz in the second row, and C bar components are cx, cy, cz in the third row. So if you substitute the values of ax, ay, az, that is 2, 0, minus 1 in the first row, bx, by, bz, 2, minus 1, 2 in the second row, and C bar values, that is 2, minus 3, 1 in the third row. And if you simplify, you will get the triple, scalar triple product A bar dot B bar cross C bar is equal to 14. Similarly, to find vector triple product, you have to use the formula A bar cross bracket B bar cross C bar is equal to B bar inside bracket A bar dot C bar minus C bar inside bracket A bar dot B bar First, you have to find the dot product of A bar dot C bar is given by AX CX AY CY plus AZ CZ. And if you substitute here AX is equal to 2 and CX is equal to 2 plus AY is equal to 0 and CY is equal to minus 3 plus AZ is equal to minus 1, CZ is equal to 1, get 3. And A bar dot B bar is equal to AX BX plus AY BY plus AZ BZ. Substituting AX equal to 2 and BX equal to 2 plus AY 0 and BY is minus 1, AZ is minus 1, BZ equal to 2, will get 2. Then you will get A bar cross B bar cross A bar is equal to B bar into 3 minus E bar into 2. If you substitute that 3 into B bar is 2X bar minus AY bar plus 2AZ bar. Minus 2 into that is C bar is equal to 2x bar minus 3a bar plus az bar. If you simplify, you will get a bar cross b bar cross c bar is equal to 2x bar plus 3ay bar plus 4z bar. So, these are the basics of vectors. It is, you have studied in intermediate class. What are the vectors, notion, mathematics. So these knowledges are very important to study the electromagnetic field theory. So next introduction topic, I will continue the next class. Thank you. Thank you, Banmoda. Thank you. Thank you.